gun through the wire. Nikita.
maybe when we got a couple of hot chocolates.
All right, our in-house clear, our land is clear for our first jump of the day. Jimmy Newman from Williston, Michigan with a Russian Daffy. Come on, Jimmy!
All right.
Woo!
Come on, Jimmy!
That is Pat Mitchell and Dave Beardsley. We call this the Trust Your Buddy Jump. Pat Mitchell is from Pacific Palisades. Dave Beardsley is from Bozeman, Montana. And they're going to do side-by-side mule kicks. All right, we're clear. Anytime you're ready, David Beardsley and Pat Mitchell, go ahead, jump. All right, there's still some more events left today. There's a last time slalom at 2:30 on the smuggler run if you want to take that in. And there's an off-ice ski party at 20's Base Lodge Bar at 3:30. Plenty of room in the cast, Buck says. Our money is in your pocket. Remember that. Next jump up, Rick Kelly. Rick Kelly is from Melrose, New York, you guys. We'll jump here in a few minutes. Anytime you're ready, Rick, we're clear. Go ahead and jump. Pursuit of money. Where's Bucky? People at one time. Pat Mitchell on one side, David Beardsley in the middle, and looks like Jimmy Newman's on the other side. And they're going to do triple tip drops.
Huh?
All right, we're clearing the in-run. We're clearing the landing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, it's
whenever you're ready, gentlemen.
I can get a lot.
Pat Mitchell, David Beardsley, Jimmy Newman with triple tip drops.
Okay, heads up on that side of the jump.
Heads up, Bozerski.
and Rick Kelly. Jumpers at the top of the inner, and I have David Beardsley and Jimmy Newman.
Yes.
Now, if everyone yells and screams loud enough, I bet we can touch these guys and we're going side by side with Rescue Toboggans.
Yeah! All right!
Beardsley shaking his head no. You guys want to do it side by side, Rex? Come on!
Yeah!
All right, that ought to get them going. I think they'll go for it. Call out of the rigs. They're getting ready to go. Dave still needs to put his goggles on, it looks like. Those Smith goggles help him clear the jump today. Now, a jump like this takes a tremendous amount of concentration. So let's save all our cheering and applause after they hit the landing.
I'm gonna see that girl again today.
We are now on the A1 chairlift, which is right above our hotel, the Continental Hotel. As you can see, the town below us is just a beautiful scenery, beautiful scenery. Over there, they're running a slalom race. It's not your average slalom race. It's done with the telemark skis, which is in the idea of a cross-country ski. What you see now is really all of Aspen. Right below us there is the base lodge of Ajax Mountain. You can see the crowd gathering at the bottom of the finish line. This shot is being taken from the first level chairlift. There's probably three more to go. As a matter of fact, I'm certain there is. You can see the detail of the mountains, they're incredible. I mean, this skiing here for every type of skier, imagine.
That zooms itself?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty slick.
Isn't that's some sight, huh? Look at those peaks.
Tom, what do you think of this whole situation?
Tonya, I can't believe that anyone who could come up here can't believe there's a God. You know, when you look out over this, look way down there. You've got hundreds of miles of these mountains.
Gentlemen.
Tom, what's the estimated height? I mean, what's the range up here?
Okay, right now we're a little over 11,000 feet, huh?
Is it 11,000?
Yeah.
Two, three guys turn this way.
And we got Buddy Hackett over there with his camera. He's a
guest celebrity here.
Am I in your way, Nick?
No, you're all set, Tom. I just want to show the folks back home.
This Ajax quad chair.
The spectacular.
This is highest off Ajax Mountain, Aspen Mountain, as it were. The The name Ajax, you know where they got that?
No.
This used to be owned by the Ajax Mining Corporation.
Oh, is that what that came from? Oh, I see.
Yeah. And that's the name Ajax. Boy, it's quite a view. Hey, we'll have to get some tomorrow off of us. No, tomorrow off of us. What a view. Hey, I got it now.
Okay.
These pictures aren't going to be too good, but...
You don't want to drag the camera too fast. Just slow.
Okay. There's the lodge over there up top. Okay.
Now that's the Summit Lodge, isn't
it? Yeah, the Summit Lodge, I think, Nick.
How many lifts have we taken up here? Is it
four lifts? Oh, jeez, I think so. Four to get up here.
Yeah, you know what to do? Is take my poles. Okay. Oh, wait, no, you can't. It's all right. You got to. Okay.
You all right?
Yeah. I'll be down here. I'm gonna do the skis.
Huh?
I'm gonna do the skis. Oh, wait, hold it.
Look better?
I know, actually, down here is all right.
Nick, the quick second Deani, looking good. Looking good.
Right there, I'm pointing.
Where's he at?
They're up there.
He's
the guy.
He
jumped him over. International here at Ajax. Buddy been known throughout the land for his seat of the pants skiing. He's just given us another demonstration of that beautiful, beautiful form which made him nationally famous here at Aspen. Well, as he fades out of view, that's a wrap. And you still see him behind there. As the sun slowly sets in the west, so too Buddy Hackett. There he is again. He's looking this way. He's got that agony of defeat look on him. Is that the?
It seems that way, Tom. I think Buddy's off. I think he's overly tired at this point.
I'm telling you, but seat of the pants skiing is none better than Buddy Hackett. Yeah.
I think she's questioning him.
Yeah. Are you you been drinking?
I think she was wondering what he was doing. And that particular, I mean, this Tom, we're talking about some serious skiing here. I mean, there's some detail to these hills. I mean, it doesn't look.
Hey, I can see Buddy getting ready for his approach. Here he comes now. He's gonna come out of the gate like gangbusters. Here he comes, folks. Here he is. He's going down. Look at those crisp turns. Look at those. All right, left. Look at that. The polling is what gets me. That precision polling. I'm telling you, put him in a mogul field, he looks marvelous. Look at that. None better. Under control. Buddy, you look great. Your camera's got a little snow on it. All day here in Aspen. Still, it's like 3:30 in the afternoon and the skis are still going strong. I'm telling you. These people like to ski, you know, and as well, the parade today, the parties tonight, the fireworks display, as a matter of fact, it's going to be right here on Little Nell, I believe. I don't know when they're going to set it up, but it's been a beautiful day of skiing. What do you think, Nick?
I'll tell you. I mean, I've skied a few years. I have never skied in conditions as excellent as these. And the funny thing about it, Tom, is the natives don't even consider these excellent. They think that this is about the poorest it could ever be.
No, I can't quite believe that because I mean we ski this and we're in heaven, and they don't even want to come out today and ski. That's to me. I don't know what they call good skiing, but I'll tell you, they're spoiled, and we're going to be awfully spoiled.
Oh, I know,
I
know.
I hate to think of leaving here. Here it is, already Saturday afternoon.
Buddy, how did you consider the skiing?
It was heaven. It was very excellent.
Would you say this is about the best skiing you've had in a long time?
This is the best skiing I had ever, let's put it that way.
Well, I'll tell you something. You know, for a 5-day, 4-night affair, this has been worth every cent that we've spent. Really, every cent. Every cent that we've spent.
Look at that beautiful town down there, huh?
Yeah. I'll tell you, that town, Tom, within probably 4 hours, is going to come alive like New York City.
This whole mountain, where we stand right now, is going to be alive with fireworks.
Yeah, that's right.
It's going to start, I believe, at 10 minutes of 7.
We're going to try and cover this event this evening the best we possibly can. I don't know how well we're going to be able to do it, but we're really going to try. I believe, Tom, that these fellas going up on the lifts now, I think they're going to be making their last run.
This is about last run of the day, I think.
They're the closed chairs starting to come up now.
Yeah, they're folding up the chairs another day. As you can see, if you look right out there, see the folded chairs coming up?
That's right. That's usually the sign.
That's probably about the last game.
Yeah, that's usually
more on the mountain today. Nope. You know, we'll pick it up tomorrow in Snowmass, though, and that'll be one heck of a.
I'll tell you, it's been a long day, Tom. It's been a long day. You can tell the excitement of these skiers. I mean, these kids party as hard as they ski. I'm telling you, I've never seen such happy faces. And you know what? By skiing this area, I can see why, really. I can honestly, truly, really feel how they feel at this point.
And you know another thing about this, Nick, today, these people, right, they've been partying since last night, probably doing the pub crawl with us. We didn't even know. They're out today. They're done skiing. They're in Little Nell's right now. That's the picture you got of it.
Yep.
Little Nell's, and we're in. You can only see the people outside. You can't even get inside. It's so packed in there. Quite a day. Quite a day.
I'll tell you, these skiers, truly, I don't know, it's even hard to describe with words. The way they enjoy themselves.
Yeah, I just wish that the people back home could be out here.
Well,
you know, I mean, we ski at home, but we don't have this type of. This is a 100% ski oriented village. I mean, that's all they eat, sleep, drink, everything ski.
I think, you know, when they see these films back home, I tell you, there's going to be some encouragement. I bet there's going to be a lot more.
We'll have to rent our own plane next year.
That sounds good.
If we intend to go.
I thought we were talking Austria next year.
Austria, Innsbruck sounds good.
Yep.
I was talking to Ralph Mitchell. He seems to think Innsbruck will be real good. And he mentioned a few other spots over there in Austria that we'll probably hit if that comes about. And it looks pretty good at this time. I figure sometime during the summer it'll be good to get started planning it.
Yeah, I think so. I'll tell you, I mean, this trip worked out so well. You know, price-wise was great. The accommodations, I thought, couldn't be any better. And the skiing, I mean, I'm still boasting about it. I just can't believe it. Tom, here's Rossi and Buddy.
Buddy looks like a tourist.
Buddy, I think, has had his share of skiing.
His camera's shutter has closed on him for good, I think. It's frozen shut. Buddy's about had it for the day. But he's ready to party hardy tonight.
I think both of them are. Look at Rossi. Look at the smile.
Yeah.
Look at that smile on Rossi's face.
Yeah. He looks marvelous. Still in one piece.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think we're going to kind of wrap it up for the afternoon.
This is the third wrap today.
Well, I'll tell you.
It's still Saturday.
I mean, the scenery around here is so spectacular that I even hate to shut the camera out. Really. Well, Tom, we'll probably see you tomorrow.
Yeah, or tonight at the fireworks.
Oh, that's right. Well, here we are at day three, skiing. Some of the sites you're seeing now are some of the chalets right on the ski slopes of the area. There's some beautiful, beautiful chalets up here. This ski area, not like the other two that we've skied in the past, it's hard to explain. The slopes are the widest that I've ever seen. This area, I think, truly caters to, well, the intermediate beginner. It has some expert areas, but it's really an area where you don't want to get yourself tired out. You know, you want to come out for a pleasurable day of skiing. This is where it's at. I don't think they have trails like we call trails. Some of these trails are, I'd say, 3 football fields in length. As you can see, the size of the trails And this is really one of the smallest areas. Well, good morning. We're here again at Snowmass. Sitting next to me is Ralph Mitchell.
Another shitty day in paradise.
I tell you, Ralph, you know, it's going to be very hard to go back home and try to ski places
like
that.
Well, this really reminds me of Wildcat.
In which way do you mean that, Ralph?
Well, the snow is on the ground.
Well, you got a point there. I think that's about the closest it's ever going to get to Wildcat. I mean, I see some detail in these areas that supposedly are intermediate beginners. I mean, I just can't believe that the life of skiing around here. How have you found skiing here the past 3 days?
I found it quite nice, quite exhilarating.
Do you feel as though you're getting a challenge out of this area today? I know Ski Mask is really not supposed to be one of the more challenging areas, but I find it, you know, I find it...
It's a cruising mountain.
It's a cruising mountain, yeah.
We're gonna have fun here.
Yeah. I mean, as you can see, you know, the area itself, the trails are... I don't even know if you can call them trails. I think you just have to call them just wide open.
The size of them, huh?
I mean, it's incredible. Mm-hmm. I mean, this... And we're not even looking at half of it now. What you're seeing right now is the whole ski slope that people are skiing. They go in and out of trees, and the amazing part of the whole thing is how well the whole area is groomed.
What you going?
Hi there.
Hi.
probably a few rock here. Look at where you're going.
Hey folks, here we are up halfway up the mountain. There's Nick and Rossi and George Nichols, and you got Ralph Mitchell over there. See, we got a few other guys around here, but I think they might have went to get some beers. So we're just kind of watching their party, and what a beautiful day. It's warm out here getting a tan here at the top of the mountain here. Okay, we'll just give it one of these zooms and we'll be off.
Money left. Hey, hey, time, buddy. You still got some money left.
No.
If you've got money left, buddy, you can't have money left on the trip.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You haven't gone home.
That's right.
You're not having a
You're going to stay here an extra day.
That's the case.
Well, you don't know where I'm going from here.
Oh?
I'm going down to New Orleans.
Oh, New Orleans. There's a bread right here. Small one.
We're in the Super Bowl this year.
Call the fuck.
Marvelous.
No, I'm having a great time with
that camera. He is. How much film did you have left?
I know it.
Excuse me, sir.
You're not bashful. Am I bashful?
I'm in control.
Right here.
Like all right, I'm ready.
Okay, they're the ones I be sick. They're the ones in the shoot, so they'll be the next ones coming. Tommy on the right, your left, Dick on the right.
It's running.
Okay, they'll be coming.
Do we know who it is?
That's somebody.
Go, Pete!
Come on, Peter!
Go, Pete! Hey, Pete!
Look at him go, will you? Look at him go, will you, Lynn? Quite a star you have there, Lynn. Superstar.
All right, Superstar. Hey. I missed the game.
Is Nikki coming down? Looking good. Looking good. All right, Nick. You look marvelous. There's Ralphie Mitchell, a little in the shadows here, but he's looking good. He's looking nice, Christy. All right, oh, just lost it there. Looking good.
Going down here?
Yeah, you know, I want to go.
You look marvelous.
All right.
It's Rowdy Rossi coming up to us now. Showing us a little bit of class here. There he goes, Rowdy Rossi. Here he is, Buddy Hackett, the one and only. We got to zoom in on this because, folks, he looks fantastic. You can tell that form anywhere. Buddy Hackett, looking fabulous. You look marvelous, buddy. All right. Woo!
Neil,
coming down, looking marvelous.
Two sets of poles. Nothing too difficult for this man.
Still
over
them. Over the tips.
Four poles.
All right, Joey, you look great.
Woo! Coming over the lift now.
There he is, looking good. Get a close up of him in there.
Here he comes.
He looks, look at that championship form. They won him the trophy in Canada.
He
looks great.
Equipment.
Woo! Here he comes, out of control, Hacker. Here he comes, look at him.
Look at this snowplow. Now watch this snowplow. You won't see it demonstrated in any other film.
There he is.
More properly than this. Look at this. What a wedge.
Look at
that. What a wedge on this man. Good.
Where is he?
Now, here comes Nick.
Nick Secondiani.
Making
looking
it look
good.
Easy. Making all of us look bad.
He does, doesn't he? He looks great.
Marvelous. Down the hill, once again, in the men's downhill here at Snowmass. Nice turns.
Yeah,
parallel turns Rowdy's doing.
He is. He looks
nice,
good.
Nice, good, tough
he looks
position.
Good. Yeah.
The speed is built up very well today. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Fast course on the course.
Here he comes. He looks good.
Looking marvelous. Keep him coming. Keep him coming. All right.
Coming down, looking good.
Yeah.
Doesn't it look easy? Here in these packed powder.
All right, Nicky.
Tough conditions here today at Snowmelt.
Come on, Nicky.
NBC News.
This is our downhill racer.
Now, here comes our man, showing a modified wedge. Looking marvelous.
This is the latest thing in turn.
Here they are, right here. Going by now. Buddy, out of control.
Hack it!
Well, good morning. Here we are, the day we leave, doing our last minute shopping, sightseeing Aspen a little bit. It's a beautiful day, beautiful day, beautiful sunshiny day. Would have been another great day to ski. As you can see here, ski lifts aren't too far from the town. People walk around from their hotel rooms right out to the slopes. Mountains behind us. Yeah, we're looking at the bottom lodge of Little Nell's, right above Ajax Mountain. People here in Aspen don't go skiing early in the morning because there's no lift lines to speak of. You know, you don't have to rush to get to the slopes by 8 o'clock in the morning to be assured of a ticket. And these people here, they get up at 9:30, get their skis on and ski for the day. No rush, no lines. Tom, good morning. How you doing?
How you doing, Nick? Cheery morning here at Ajax.
I was just showing the folks back home the Ajax mine that we skied the second day, right above our hotel room. Really, I was just saying how convenient it is to be able to put your skis on, or your boots on, walk right to the mountain, a few hundred feet.
Yeah, it's about 150 feet from our door to the lift at Little Nell, which you're looking at right now over here on the left.
Yep.
And just situated perfectly.
Perfect.
As we said before, time and time again, another shitty day in paradise.
Yep, you're right.
Oh, look at that.
There it is again. I think I had it in the early in the program, a Continental Hotel that we're staying at, right above. Just a small segment of Ajax Mountain. I mean, the first chairlift goes up to that. What you see is the peak, but there's actually three more chairlifts after that. As you can tell, the town isn't booming yet. These are free shuttle buses that are offered to the public here. You don't have to pay for any transportation anywheres. His buddy and George, they're doing some last minute shopping. Tommy waving. Could you tell me the name of this place?
Yeah, it's Carl's Drug. No, it's Aspen Drug, actually.
Aspen Drug. We're at Aspen Drug right now. These people, very congenial people in Aspen. We've had nothing but great hospitality from them. Great. Who's Carl? Is Carl here? No, Carl. And there's a young lady there ducking behind the counter.
On a Monday morning?
It'll be thousands of miles away by tonight.
We're all wanted in 12 states. Why do you think we're here?
Well, I can tell you why you're here, the scheme. We're viewing one of the watering holes that we patronized here one of the nights. Here showing some of the shops around Aspen. Oh, here comes Tom and Buddy.
Here we are recreating the Aspen pub crawl of the Friday night fame. And as you can tell, everybody is going right down. And there's the shaft over there on your left, Nick. We crawled to that place, I thought.
Oh, that's right, that's right.
We barely crawled out of there.
Yeah.
And as you saw Cooper Street, we were there. And we'll be looking for Annie's and O'Leary's, I believe it is. We crawled to those two, and the Paragon was also crawled to.
Yep, yep.
Okay, you want to move on down to the rest of the pubs? We're down here at O'Leary's Pub. I think we're on East Diamond Street. And this is one of the other pubs we crawled to at O'Leary's. And right next door, you got Annie's. Little Annie's, we crawled over there as well.
I'll tell you, that was what we ate last night, wasn't it?
Yeah, we ate there several nights.
Yeah, the food, I'll tell you, for the price, it's probably the most reasonable eating area in Aspen, and the food is outstanding.
Sure is.
I mean, ribs like I've never, I don't really care for ribs, but ribs that you can't even possibly touch back home for the price. Tom, you know one thing kind of, I think people back
What's
home
that?
Would like to know what the Aspen Crawl really means and what it's all about.
Well, Nick, the Aspen Pub Crawl, as we know it, we came here Friday night and we really didn't know what it was. We just happened into one of the pubs and found a lot of wall-to-wall people. And I'd say we were there for 20 minutes or half an hour and all of a sudden we heard a whistle going. And everybody left the pub and they were wondering where they went. And they told us they were going to another, they were crawling. And we didn't know what it was. So actually what we did was follow them to the next pub. And we started having shots and beers in the next pub, which was packed with most of the same people that had crawled from one to the other. And when we got there, we weren't exactly sure, but we saw people with tags on. We had officers in this. It was an organized transport of people from one pub to another. As we found out all throughout the night, we hit some five or six pubs. And I'll tell you, I don't remember the last couple because I think I was carried home. It was one heck of a good time.
I'll tell you something. I've never seen Buddy so happy that night. Did you notice that?
Geez.
I mean,
he was marvelous.
I tell you, I think Buddy will agree. Buddy, tell me the truth. Was this the best time you've had in a long time?
This is the best time I really had in a long time. Really enjoyed it.
Well, tell me a little bit about your stay here. Did you feel as though Aspen was what you expected?
Wow, it was a lot more than what I expected.
Was it? In which way do you mean?
I thought it was going to be a rich, snobby town, but it's the friendliest town I've ever gone in. I mean, when you can crawl with maybe, 500 other people?
I don't know how many there were, buddy, but there was an awful lot of them.
And no fights, all friendly, just a great time overall.
Yeah, I think we've met some really nice people here.
Yeah.
I've had a great time.
Nice place, America, huh?
Yeah,
great.
Great country is America.
Yeah. Didn't we meet that guy the other night?
Well, I think this is the guy that Buddy ended up with one night. Not good. Very quiet.
Yeah.
Arch Nichols right now viewing the town.
Monday morning photograph. Not the best.
Shot viewing Ajax Mountain right from the main street, looking right up at it. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful sight. There's another place that we crawled to. I don't even want to say crawl because, you know, it doesn't sound very good for the folks back home, but we had a good time. You know, it was nice. It was a nice take-in. People very friendly. All participated in, you know, a good time.
Yeah, you're right. This was, I think, the last place we crawled to.
Yeah.
I vaguely remember it. It was, we just barged in there. This street, as you can see, as you look up and down this street was literally wall-to-wall with people. Going into this
place.
It was some sight, I'll tell you.
wall to wall. These people around here really do party, don't they, huh?
Oh, that's all this town does. Yeah. That is what this town is for.
Skiing party. Skiing party. I'll tell you, did you notice, though, I mean, there was an awful lot of very, very, you know, down-to-earth people, but I'll tell you, I've noticed one other thing. There seem to be two classes of people here. People, you know, the average person, and then you've got the very, very well-to-do.
Oh.
As we can tell by some of the shops
that we don't go into.
Well, we try to stay away from, you know, the furs and the diamonds and...
Yeah. You have to ask the price. You don't want to go in.
You're right. You're absolutely right. It's a great place if you had plastic to use at no expense.
You better be staying with steel, I'll tell you that.
Exactly. Well, here we are, packing up, ready to go. They shot his home, our bedroom balcony, looking out at the ski lift of Ajax Mountain and little Nels that we've spoken about several times. I mean, if anyone wants to have a view from the hotel room, it couldn't beat this one. This is beautiful. Unfortunately, the mountain runs up the side behind these chalets, so you can't really get to the side of the mountain. Well, you can see a little bit. It goes right up there. You can see how convenient it is to step out your hotel door and walk right down to the ski lift. These are just some of the surrounding mountains, which surrounds actually Aspen. Aspen is actually built right in a valley surrounded by all mountains. Here we have Buddy sadly packing for the trip home.
That with great memories.
Yeah, Buddy's really really enjoyed this whole. I think we all have. I think we've all enjoyed it.
Oh, yeah.
The accommodations are good. People are very nice. But I think we're all anxious to get home now. The weather's been remarkably warm. Every day it's been in the 40s. 50s. You know, where else can you possibly get those conditions back home other than spring conditions, really? And this is what they are, spring conditions. Well, I guess I'm going to get ready to pack and put everything away. It's been a great trip.
Very good.
We really, really, really enjoyed it.
Excellent,
Buddy,
excellent trip.
Maybe we'll do it again sometime.
To
To honor America, we present Grammy Award winner Wynton Marsalis to play our national anthem.